Now comes the tough part, if I may so say, selection of the team of the tournament. In terms of personnel, overall, it looks to be a settled outfit. It looks as if the players take their spots. But there are some places where we might have to debate and shoo some people off because some others seem better for that spot. So Ananya and Gohar, are you set to take the hot seat or the selector's spot?
Yes, let's go.
All right, let's look at the first, let's look at top four in our team of the tournament, and we'll have a discussion around a pool of players that can possibly make that top four in our team. And we have the likes of Chamari Attapattu, Smriti Mandana, Harmanpreet Kaur, Harleen Deol, Deepti Sharma, and Shefali Verma up for discussion. Let's see who our top four is. So, Ananya, let's start with you. Are you pretty much settled on the opening combination?
Yeah, I think the openers just select themselves. The two top run getters of the tournament, Chamari Attapattu and Smriti Mandana. So, I mean, I don't think there should be any debate there. I hope there isn't, because I mean, even though they're both left-handers, you the quality that they are, I think both of them just are shoo-ins. But number three and four for me. So I've given Harmanpreet Kaur a promotion to number three. And Deepti Sharma for me is number four. So those are the top four that I've selected. And hopefully there's not debate over the openers.
You can hope, but like we've seen throughout the tournament, that there are these old school thoughts that prevent, say, bowling a left arm spinner against a left-handed opener. So Gohar, do you see us going in an old school way and say, two left-handers, that's a bit too much in the opening slot. Let's bring in a Shefali Verma from somewhere. Are you kind of that? And what's your top four like?
No, not really. I mean, I absolutely, you know, these two were outstanding, the way they've played, and being the top two run getters, I think they've been fantastic, whether it was outgoing, as I said, in a T20 game. I mean, what matters is, you know, how you play, how you score runs. I think it doesn't matter, you know, whether it is an incoming bowler or outgoing bowler. I think there's no time for, you know, to think about all these factors in a T20 game, I think. And the way both of them are, they're aggressive openers, you know, they're fearless. They want to go for those strokes and use the power play to the best. I think there's absolutely no doubt about Smriti Mandana and Chamari Attapattu being the openers in this thing. And I have given Deepti Sharma the number three spots simply for the fact is, you know, we've not seen the number three opener, I mean, like number three batters from all the three sides, you know, they've never really got going. So maybe Deepti Sharma, you know, being a left-hander again and coming in, and, you know, she's good with her sweep shots. She's good, you know, using that pace from the bowlers and getting those singles. I think she is my number three. And Harman, as always, she's always been playing at number four. She's got the firepower. She's got those big hits.
Let me present one final time the Shefali Verma's case, because our top four, we need attacking right-handed batters somewhere, isn't it? This is one number that interests me, the strike rate again. 150 is the strike rate that she batted with. The runs, there aren't enough runs to show, just 30 in two matches. Does she make a case to fit in either of these slots? Ananya, you've been vociferously shaking your head.
I feel like, you know, the numbers just don't stack up. And if we're selecting a team of the tournament, we're also looking at, you know, the conditions that they're playing in. And we saw the final pitch that was played on. I cannot see Shefali Verma scoring runs on that pitch. I think she will struggle where there's no pace on the ball. And so I just don't buy that argument that, you know, just because of her strike rate, Shefali Verma makes it.
All right, case, your argument's accepted. Let's lock our top four with Chamari Attapattu, Smriti Mandana, Harmanpreet Kaur, and Deepti Sharma. Three and four can be decided perhaps based on match situation. Let's move to the middle order and lower middle order, 5, 6, 7. That's a bit, I expect more discussions here because of the because of the performances that we've seen in the tournament. The possible candidates are Sunelis, Shashikala Sirivardhane, Harleen Diol, Sushma Verma, Tanya Bhatia also. So, Gohar, you take it first. 5, 6, 7 for you.
For me, Sunelis comes in at number 5. The way she's, got the game for the velocity in the first game, coming and attacking. I think after Harman, in the middle overs, we need somebody like that. I think it's Sunelis at number 5. And then I have Sushma Verma coming in at number 6. Or it could be Harleen Diol. It's again going to be, it depends on how the match goes and how the top order performs. And it's going to be either Harleen or Sushma Verma for me. And then Shashikala walks in. The way she's batted, run a ball. I think when Harman, in case Harman is around, the way she takes those singles and doubles, she's a cheeky customer. So I think Shashikala walks in at number 7.
Shashikala at 7. Sunelis and Sushma Verma are what Gohar picked. Ananya, how's your setup here in the middle order? There's also Tanya Bhatia, if you can consider her, because I believe Sushma Verma would be our wicket keeper if she makes the cut.
Yeah, so my selections are very, very similar to Gohar's. I've penciled in Sunelis at 5. I have Harleen Diol at 6. Sushma Verma at 7. Sushma Verma will obviously be the wicket keeper. Then there's no place for Tanya Bhatia. I just feel like that knock that Sushma played in the first game, it was a match-winning knock. Yes, she didn't set the stage alight, but I think it was one of those knocks that she's known for, to control the innings in that middle order when the top order fails. So Sushma Verma takes the gloves, comes in at number 7. So my 5, 6, 7 are Sunelis, Harleen Diol and Sushma Verma.
Let me put a joker in the pack. No place for someone like Veda Krishnamurthy, who's kind of been there, done that, but just didn't fire in this tournament.
Again, that just feels like one of those potential things. You don't want to pick her because you know what she's capable of. She didn't fire in the tournament. You know, had she won that first game for velocity, maybe you would have considered her. But she just didn't make that impact contribution. So, for me, Veda's a no.
All right, let's move to the lower order now. 8, 9, 10, 11. Let's start with you, Gohar, again. You penciled Shashikala as your 7, given if Sushma or Harleen come in. So she also perhaps will move down if they both of them come in. So let's keep Shashikala as your 8. Who are your 9, 10, 11? Who are the picks? There are Sophie Eccleston, Radha Yadav, Julan Goswami, Shikha Pandey and Leah Kasparek. These are the pool that we can choose from.
Yeah, for me, and number 9 would be either Julan Goswami or Shikha Pandey, because as I said, they've been very economical and on this kind of track of medium pace, and not giving away runs is more important than going for wickets and attacking the batsmen. So I think one of them will be my number 9, but because Julan Goswami is more experienced than Shikha Pandey, and she's had one more game to prove herself again, the way she's bowled in the final, I think I'll have to go with Julan Goswami. Also, she takes the edge because she can clear the boundary with her that long lever, the way she plays, and those long legs that makes even a good length ball drive or an over pitch for her. So she manages that very well. For me, Julan Goswami is my number 9, and then comes the left arm spinners, Sophie Eccleston and Radha Yadav. Probably too late, but we have batsmen to, Sophie Eccleston is, I believe she's got those she can hit those big hits as well. And Radha Yadav was known for that gritty batting display. So a little too late coming into the thing. But I think Sophie Eccleston and Radha Yadav is my 10 and 11.
Interesting. We also have Salma Khatun as our candidate in one of these spots. Ananya, does she make the cut? And what what's the composition of your, I mean, what are we fixing on for 8, 9, 10, 11?
I think for me, it was a toss-up between Shashikala, Sirivardhane and Salma Khatun. But again, since we're going for that four overseas only, it became a question of, you know, which one. Yes, I think Salma Khatun was brilliant in that final, but I think Shashikala Sirivardhane just picked her simply because she also contributes with the bat. I thought, you know, she was really good in the final. And, you know, I probably have a Shashikala Sirivardhane bias, so I'm going with her. And that's why she picked Salma Khatun. Someone I also was really impressed by was Lee Kasparek. But again, I think it's like that Shikha Pandey argument where we didn't see too much of her. You know, she doesn't have the numbers to back her. So she probably misses out for the same reason. So, you know, I have Shashikala Sirivardhane at 8. I feel like Gohar and I are working with the same brain because we picked the exact same 11. So it is Jhulan Goswami, Sophie Eccleston and Radha Yadav. So,
hey Gohar, here's someone who's missing out from your club, the left-arm spinners club, Ekta Bisht. And again, is it because she played one match less is the reason why she missed out?
It definitely is. Not only Ekta Bisht, I think Lee Kasparek was also, you know, brilliant, even with the kind of pace she's bowled, with the kind of, you know, tossing up the ball and, you know, not letting the batsman go for those big hits. I think both of them didn't make the cut, is obviously because they didn't have that extra game to, you know, showcase what they're capable of, I think. But whatever they had, whatever little that they could, I think, because the second game was a 47-run small total, I think they could not really show what they're capable of. But I think both of them were brilliant with whatever they could in those two games.
Interesting how much of our decisions were skewed because of that 47-run match. But Ananda, do you think our 11 has... is a bit low on firepower in that middle order department, because there's nobody who can kind of go from the get going from the word go. There's Harleen, who showed promise in one match. Shashikala Sirivardhane kind of perhaps is in her past her prime in terms of her hitting capability. Sunelis, we saw what she did in the first game, but again on a turning wicket, on a rank turner, perhaps she's a suspect. Sushma Verma, again, we are not sure if she can kind of continue to play those big shots. And Harmanpreet Kaur's strike rate is just 100 in this tournament. So given that we are selecting 11 based on what we saw over the past week in the grounds of Sharjah Cricket Ground, is our 11 a bit raw in terms of that middle order, late middle order firepower with the bat?
I mean, I guess you can say that, but I think, again, we are selecting a team for the conditions that we saw there. And I think that the requirement was people who are able to turn the strike over and, of course, find the odd boundary. I think it's more about being smart rather than, you know, the brute force. We saw how Pooja Vasprakar struggled simply because, and Richa Ghosh struggled because they were looking for the boundary. And, you know, if we're picking a team for conditions in Sharjah, I think, you know, while there may not be that big hitter that you want in a T20 game, I think you have enough people who are able to manipulate the field and probably be a little more innovative and smart in these conditions, which is what you require. So, you know, while the strike rates are not flattering, I think, you know, these guys will be able to do the job.
It's a pity that cricket flows in a manner where performances or players are selected based on their ability with the bat or with the ball, but not much weightage can be attributed to fielding, which often turns out to be the difference. That's where someone like Nataktan Chantam misses out for us in our 11. We can probably have her in our 12th, and so could be someone like Salma Khatun or someone else. So I had penciled in my 11 Salma Khatun ahead of Shashikala, but that's why I call it pencil, because it got erased because Salma has been thrown off. So your 12th pick for 12th person, is it going to be overseas or are there any Indians featuring? Gohar?
Yeah, for me, because we only can have 4 overseas players, I think we can give them a chance, you know, be the 12th. And because of the way they have performed and, you know, on the field, especially Dotin and Chantham, I think they were brilliant the way Dotin saved that in the second game. I think she was fantastic and she's very athletic. So is Chantham. I think that save, that acrobatic dive and that you know Jemima Rodrigues catch that was like a flying and she was brilliant. I think either of them and considering Salma Khatun's performance under pressure chasing a small total defending a small total, I think Salma Khatun was brilliant trapping Shashikala the way she did, and she used all her experience, you know, using different pace to get those 3 wickets. I think she probably either of 3 of them makes the cut for. But if you consider 12th man, you know, and maybe Chantham is the 12th for me because of the way she, and probably it wasn't fair for her to not, you know, get to bat in. But she was definitely brilliant and outstanding in the field in both the games. So I'll go for Chantham as my 12th.
I don't think we can disagree on having someone like Chantham in our as a part of our squad, Ananya. But suppose, say, our Harmanpreet Kaur gets injured, you can't field Chantham because you can only have 4 overseas at a time. So who can we also have as an Indian player in our 12th, as the 12th person?
So I'm going to throw in a left field selection that, you know, is purely based on fielding and purely based on what I've seen over the years. So if Chantham is our overseas 12th, which I thoroughly agree with, the Indian name, she didn't get a game over the last couple of years, but Arundhati Reddy is someone who you could, since you're selecting your 12th purely based on fielding, Arundhati Reddy is someone who on that bench is probably the best fielder amongst the Indians. You saw her through the World Cup, you know, covering the boundary and doing very well in the infield. I've seen her in Hyderabad. She's probably one of the best fielders in our state team as well. So, you know, it's a left field selection. She didn't play. You're probably wondering why the hell I'm taking her name. But, you know, if it's for fielding, Arundhati Reddy would probably be my Indian 12th.
Fair choice, Arundhati and Natakkan Chantham as the 12th, mainly based on their fielding abilities. This is how our 11 and including the 12th person looks like. What's your team of the tournament, team of Women's T20 Challenge 2020 like? Do let us know in the comment section wherever you are watching this video. And once again, Gohar and Ananya, thanks for your time. And for all of you, thanks for watching. That's it from us. Signing off on Avnir Presents The Outside View, powered by WTF Sports.